Coach Cliff of Outlaws right here in Tarzana, California. Can't stop smiling because of the performance that Bernard Hopkins had over Tavoris Clout. You were excited about every second of the fight?
I was so charged up while watching that because, hey, Cloud is he's young, he's strong, he's talented, and B-Hop, man, just the skills, they're just sick when I'm watching.
What skills did you see? What did you see in the fight?
This is what he knows how to do. He knows how to move his head just a certain amount. He knows exactly where to stand and where to position himself. When he has to move quick, he does, but when he doesn't move quick. He almost, you could see him, he purposely misses punches so that you walk into the next shot. So he'll throw a left.
Show me an example.
Well, he'll throw a left hook. He'll throw a left hook, and you can see he's wanting a guy to like to bring his head down. He's throwing kind of almost behind his head, then boom, he'll hit you with an uppercut. He'll throw a right hand and then walk into the left hook. I mean, and he's not even doing it fast because he's not young anymore. But I mean, the skills are just sick. I mean, I loved every second of that fight. I mean, I just couldn't believe what I was watching.
Who would you want to see him fight next?
I'd like to see him fight everybody because, I'd like to see him fight Andre Ward, although he said no way.
No. But do you want to see him unify the division?
Yeah, that would be fantastic, especially, I'm an older fighter, right? And
that's why you love him so much? You guys are close at age?
Well, it's close at age, but also to watch that kind of mastery of the technical aspects of the sport. I mean, it's an art. He is such a smart guy. He's thinking so much in there about what he's doing. He gets himself in great shape. And I mean, that was just a masterpiece. And Cloud should win that fight. He should win that fight 9 out of 10 times if it was anybody but B-Hop.
What do you say about the fans cheering for B-Hop throughout the fight, yelling B-Hop, B-Hop?
I mean, I think they had some appreciation for the skill. Yeah, I mean, some people, a wild fight is more exciting. You're not 48 years old and going to fight a wild fight against a strong young kid like that. That'd be the dumbest thing in the world. Why would he do something like that? He's still champ. He's still making money. Still part of Golden Boy.
What do you say about this? We've never seen someone at 48 win a championship. How many years do you think Hopkins has under his belt? Will he break the record of 55? 50?
I think unless something happens and hopefully never gets hurt, at the way he's fighting and the kind of skills he has and the kind of he stays in shape between fights. He loves being in the gym, and that's what I read. I don't know him personally. But you can see it in
his
performance.
You can see most people like gain a lot. He's always in shape.
I don't know. I mean, he may be 54, 55 and still kicking people's ass because he's got so much more skill. It's a true definition of the word master.
That would be something. 55 years old, world champion. So look out for Bernard Hopkins. He's doing big things, breaking records. Do you think his record will ever be broken?
Records always get broken, and certainly we know more about keeping people in shape and training people and eating right than we ever did before.
Okay, so if you had to go with either Marquez or Sergio Martinez, who else is up there?
I don't think anybody.
You don't think from the current generation, nobody?
No, I don't think so. I think Martinez relies on speed and reflex.
Okay.
And doesn't have
Marquez.
And I don't want to take anything away from him. He's great. Marquez, doesn't exactly have what B-Hop has. I think he relies a little bit on, some speed and obviously a big right hand, right?
Right. I thought you were going to say something else. So there you have it, Coach Cliff, right here at OutlawsVSNewReporting.com. I'm Isaac Beck reporting.